Hello and welcome back again to MBAbullshit.com. So our topic for this video is basic capital budgeting. Alright? So remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. But before we move on with this video, you should first understand present value and net present value. Okay? So if you don't know these two topics yet, then I suggest that you first watch my other free videos on these two topics. Okay, so let's get right down to it. So first of all, I'd like to answer the question first. What is capital budgeting? Okay, so when do we say we're capital budgeting or whatever in business school? Well, basically it answers other questions, and such as example, you would like or you're thinking about doing a new project for your business. Capital budgeting is when we ask ourselves, is it worth it? Okay, is it worth it to put money or capital, also known as capital, into this project? Is it worth it? Is it a good decision? Is it a good deal in terms of money, in terms of earning, to put money in this new proposed project? It could also mean, is it worth it to use money to buy a new machine? If you think about how much this new machine will earn compared to the costs of getting money to buy this machine. Okay? Or is it worth putting money in a new business as a whole? Maybe you're thinking of putting up a brand new whole business, or maybe you're thinking of buying an existing business. Okay? Is it worth it to put money in this business, or to pay money for this business? Alright, so as an example, let's look at valuing a project. Okay, this is just a simple example. Now let's say that you are thinking of borrowing $1,000 from the bank, which charges 5% interest rate, so that you can buy a new machine for $1,000. Okay? And let's pretend that this machine will earn you $260 for 2 years. Okay? And let's say that you can only use it for 2 years, because after 2 years it's gonna break down. But you can sell it for scrap at $500 in the end, after the 2 years. So my question is, will you win or will you lose money in this new project or in this new machine? It doesn't matter if it's a machine or a project or both. Okay? So will you win or lose money in this project? Now if you just get if you look at 260 for 2 years, that's like 520, plus you earn another 500, you have 1,020. And 1,020 is higher than $1,000. So maybe you think that you will earn money from this project. However, it is not as simple as that. Because remember, the concept of time value of money, future value of money, and present value of money. So if we want to find out if this is a good deal or not, we should first find out the sum of the present values of both the cash outflow and the cash inflows. Alright? So we first look at the present values of these. And when we do that, the formula, as you remember from the present value formula will look something like this. Okay, don't panic. Okay, don't panic. Where did we get this? This $1,000 is just the same as the $1,000 that you are paying for the machine. This 0.05 is just the same as the 5% interest rate that you are paying the bank. This $260 here is just the same as the $260 earnings that you'll get. And it happens for 2 years. This negative one is the $260, represents the going back 1 year to the present value of the first $260. And this negative 2 power over here represents the 2 years, 1, 2, that this $260 will go back, okay, so that we can find out the present value, alright? And this $500 over here represents the $500 you will earn at the end of 2 years when you sell the whole machine. Alright? Simple as that. So now, before we move on, I have a reminder. In more advanced problems, we will use the WAC, the weighted average cost of capital, instead of the bank interest rate at 5%. Okay? But this is just a very simple example, so I will just use the bank interest rate. And also, in more advanced problems, we will include other factors such as horizon value and growth rate, etc. Now, don't worry if you don't understand these things right now, because it is not needed for this basic example or for this basic problem. Okay, so now we have this, and if we move on to the other slide, here it is, exactly the same. Oh yeah, remember, this negative zero over here is because this $1,000, this negative $1,000, is the $1,000 that you are paying it, that you are paying today. And if you are paying it today, you're bringing it back not 1 year, but you're bringing it back 0 years, because it is today. All right? So now, if we add this all up and multiply this all together, all right, we will come up with this negative $63, okay, as the present value of this project, of this machine, after we borrowed money to buy it and after we've earned money from it. Okay, so this means that this project is worth a negative $63, or you will lose $63 if you do this project. So therefore, don't do it. Okay? However, if this was a positive number, if it was a positive number, then in that case, you would earn money, and therefore you should do the project. But in our case, it's negative, so don't do it. All right? So now you understand the basic concept, so you can move on to our next video, if you like, on capital budgeting, valuing a business. All right, remember to share it if you like it. On Twitter, our name is MBAbullshit, or please share my YouTube link on your Facebook or on your email to your friends. Goodbye, and have a great day.